right, let's go. Let's see what's in the school then. We're training them how to be
and
Nazis.
And remember, democracy is weak. It relies on the votes of the foolish masses who are incapable of choosing strong leaders. Constitutional government fosters weakness. The rejection of republicanism is what won the last war for Germany, and it will bring us victory over these stupid Americans.
That's not what they told us at the academy.
Let's look at everything. And everyone.
Oh. James T. Kirk. His school looked nothing like this. Mr. Spock observes that the human education system was once full of inaccuracies. Lieutenant Commander Ellis looks at this artifact of the 20th century in disbelief.
Yeah, we've come far.
Dr. McCoy, remembering his old xenobiology classes. Captain Hauptmann, looks like he'll fit right into German society in 20 years. Frau Humperdinck looks like she can't wait for the day to end. A young German girl. A young German boy. The desks of the kindergarten of Gothos. A young German boy. The teacher's desk.
Teacher's chair?
This seems pointless. This appears to be a picture of Kaiser Wilhelm II. This is a map of Western Europe. This seems pointless. This seems pointless. This wooden floor looks quite clean.
No need to sweep this one up.
A chalkboard. The exteriors of other buildings are visible through these great windows. A light hangs from the ceiling. A cupboard. It is currently shut. This door leads back out to the street. Some blocks with alphabetical letters and numbers on them. A table with some blocks and a book on it.
A bell?
Frau Humperdinck. Look. The teacher's desk.
Bones?
A male human in excellent physical condition. I see that the tricorder is not very good at judging character.
Not at all.
A middle-aged human female in average physical condition. A pre-adolescent human female in good physical condition. A pre-adolescent human male in good physical condition.
All right, Spock.
An ordinary oil painting, approximately 30 years old. I detect no unusual readings from it.
I don't think we'll find anything in anything, but...
The map does not register as unusual.
Let's see what he says.
There are no unusual readings from the desk, Captain. Captain, another abnormally high reading emanating from the chalkboard.
Another horcrux. We need that.
The tricorder finds nothing unusual with these blocks.
Anything inside this cupboard?
I am scanning the contents of the cupboard. Some chalk, some pencils, and a blackboard eraser. I detect no unusual readings from any of the objects.
I'm surprised we even know what some of this stuff is. I guess the tricorder helps with that.
Fluorescent illumination, Captain. A distinct anachronism. The light is encased in shatterproof glass, and the light is far more energy efficient than is typical for illumination of this period. Aside from these anomalies, there are no unusual readings. Panes of glass in a wooden frame. There's nothing unusual about them, Captain.
These desks?
I detect nothing unusual about the desks.
C.
Save new game. Replace.
Let's talk to everybody.
It's been a long time since I've been in school.
Fascinating. And I thought 20th century hospitals were grim.
And yet the very best people who taught in a place like this had the power to uplift people's lives, to teach them knowledge, principles, and self-awareness.
Very good.
This was a battlefield where millions of unknown soldiers of knowledge fought to elevate humanity from barbarism.
Question is, are they succeeding in this case?
I wonder what Dickens would have written if he had been exposed to a place like this.
Talking.
Shh, I wouldn't interrupt Captain Hartman. You wouldn't like him when he's angry.
What is he, the Hulk?
Boys and girls, let me introduce you to an example of inferior Republican stock.
I'm not Republican.
Lieutenant Colonel Jimmy Kirk. Tell us, Kirk, how can you defend the ludicrous American system?
I see no reason to defend anything, Captain. These children are, in spite of your efforts to indoctrinate them, quite capable of growing up to become adults who will make up their own minds.
Excellent answer. I like that one.
I am not interested in a debate, Hauptmann. If your system is so superior to America's, how come you're losing the war?
Good point. Still like the first one better.
Why don't we put it up to a vote? You have a choice between a system that gives you leaders who will oppress you for life, or a system which, imperfect though it may be, allows you to influence your leaders and gives you a chance to bring them to account. I see no reason to defend anything, Captain.
This one.
They will listen to what we tell them, because we know more than you. It is the best interest of society for them to obey us without question.
Whose society is it in the best interest of? Yours or theirs?
Theirs. Murmur. Be quiet, Akshnell.
Children, tell this American fool that you will obey me without question.
Children, tell us how you really feel. Be honest to yourself as well as to others.
Go, Kirk.
I'm sick of listening to Captain Hauptmann yelling at us.
Go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Captain Hauptmann treats everyone like they're the enemy, even us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I never want to listen to Captain Hauptmann again as long as I live.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, seeing that they want to obey you without question.
I will not tolerate such insults. The Baron will make you all pay.
Get the hell out of here. Put your tail between your legs while you're at it. Yay!
Are all Americans as handsome as you, Colonel Kirk?
Why, I... Balls, you're never at a loss for words, you answer her.
Lieutenant Colonel Kirk, when I grow up, will you teach me how to fly as good as you?
Well,
I guess we're ready to ship you to the academy, Jim.
Wow! A real American pilot! Can I shoot you as an escaped prisoner?
No.
What?
Frau Humperdinck! Colonel Kirk von that they shoot him! Is that fair?
Right, kid.
hi. Aw. Very shy, Colonel.
Aw, she's cute.
A young German girl named Maria.
Alright, so that's Maria. That's Ingrid.
A young German girl named Ingrid.
Now they have names.
A young German boy named Gerhard.
And all this time I thought it was a girl saying all that speech.
A young German boy named Wolfgang.
Wolfgang.
Frau Humperdinck.
Humperdinck. Let's talk to her. Let's not just take this, although I'd love to take it.
Herr Kirk, can I help you?
Yes, I'd like to ask a question. What do you think about the war? What can you tell me about Trelane? These children are something, aren't they? I didn't realize they let mad dogs teach children.
Uh-huh.
You know, I've heard that chalkboards can be very dangerous to children. The
right.
Chalk is very bad for the lungs. Maybe I should remove it.
Anything
what
else?
Do you think about the war?
It's horrible. With any luck, my students won't have to fight in such a war once they get older.
True.
Herr Kirk, can I help you?
Yes, I'd like to ask a question. What do you think about the war? What can you tell me about Trelane?
The Baron. Such a charming
Oops,
man.
Sorry, guys.
If all the military and Gothos were like him, it would be a better place to live.
I very much doubt that.
Herr Kirk, can I help you?
Yes, I'd like to ask a question. What do you think about? What can you tell me of these children or something, aren't they?
They are a little rambunctious, aren't they?
Nah, they're awesome.
Herr Kirk, can I help you?
Yes, I'd like to ask a question. What do you think about the... What can you... These children... I didn't realize they let mad dogs teach children.
He's a rather enthusiastic officer.
You're way too kind.
Herr Kirk, can I help you?
Yes, I'd like to ask a question. What do you think about the war? What can these... I didn't realize they let mad dogs teach children. You know, I've heard that chalkboards can be very dangerous to children.
You want to remove my chalkboard? Nein, absolutely not. I wouldn't consider it unless you gave me a letter from the superintendent telling me to do this.
Well, he's playing poker. I assume we'll have to help him win some rounds in poker or something.
Herr Kirk, can I help you?
Yes, I'd like to ask a question. What do you think about the... What can these... I didn't realize... You know, what do you think about the war?
It's horrible.
Oh, I didn't look at this clock.
This clock seems permanently fixed on 5 minutes to 3.
Yet I hear it.
Fascinating. The mechanism is working correctly. My tricorder detects the passage of time. And yet, the exact time count remains unchanged. The actual clock is unremarkable, Captain. No anomalies or unusual power readings.
Hmm. Because time, I guess, technically is not moving or something like that? Because this is all like a simulation.
Fluorescent illumination.
Oh, I did look at that.
Jim, we don't have time for any of us to teach them.
Well, education is important, Bones.
What is it, Colonel? What is it, Colonel?
They look a little small for me.
You want to start a fight? My dad'll come after you if you try something.
Oh my, we have a little Draco Malfoy going on here. Why do I keep coming back to Harry Potter?
What is it, Colonel?
I'm gonna kidnap all of you.
Jim, we don't have time for games. What do you hope to accomplish with that?
I want to learn my ABCs.
Aren't you a little old to be playing with blocks, Jim?
Very funny, Bones. It looks like it's out of my reach. I don't think Frau Humperdinck would appreciate us tampering with her lights. 20th century equivalent of the captain's chair. I always want to paint a mustache on a painting like that. This map looks a little out of proportion.
Jim, the last thing we need is to be hauling around a portrait of the Kaiser.
No effect. No effect.
Please, take anything, but not that. Education represents our children's future, and education cannot succeed if it is neglected or if teachers do not have the proper tools.
Oh my.
Freud would have something very interesting to say about that.
No effect. No effect.
Take kid.
No effect.
Okay.
No effect. No effect.
Alright, Spock, subdue her.
My dimensions are too large to effectively fit in this frame. What do you hope to accomplish with that? Captain, do you have a reason to believe the cupboard's contents are crucial to our success?
Yeah, it's closed. We must see it.
Jim, we don't have time for any of us to teach them.
Well, education is important, Bob.
Given that the room receives ample natural illumination, destroying the artificial lighting of this schoolroom would have no effect on our mission.
All right, let's go. We will go talk to the mister playing poker.
Save new game. Replace previous.
Who is this way? Still have to see that way. And he's back here.
And what is the Bluffmeister up to this time?
He doesn't bluff. He just complains about everything.
I do not. If I did, I would have hit the ceiling with my last hand.
You don't. You deal with it.
There's no hand worse than the one you deal yourself.
Hmm.
Welcome, friends. Can I help you?
What can you tell me about the war? What can you tell me? Can you help me get into the... I need you to spread a rumor about a chalkboard. What can you tell me? I need you to spread a rumor about a chalkboard.
You say you need me to convince Herr Schiller to give you the kindergarten blackboard? Do not know why, but I would do anything if you could get the commander to issue a transfer for my son.
Huh. Oh boy, this is getting complicated.
Welcome, friends. Can I help you?
What can you tell me? What can you... Can you help me get...
I would lend you a stake to answer this game, but it appears that I will have to win...
Hmm.
Save new, replace previous.
Should we, put our money in?
Welcome to the game, Colonel.
3 hours later.
My God! Where did you learn to play poker, Colonel?
Good.
Starfleet Academy.
Starfleet Academy. Nice. I was afraid it was a minigame that would have been annoying.
We have enough money to purchase the clock, Captain. I suggest we do so without delay.
Yeah, let's do that then. Before we do that, though...
I am more fond of beer than schnapps, Herr Kirk. It is fortunate that Fräulein Gretel has such a superb brew.
I do not drink anything more potent than beer.
Hmm.
This is rather poor schnapps.
Oh.
I should be offended that you would offer me such a brew. But I'm quick to forgive, Colonel Kirk.
But of course. Now, would anyone like to be tied up? Perhaps you.
Our safety is not endangered here, Captain. Attempting to subdue people will only make things worse. Our safety is...
Okay. All the money we have.
This is money. A lot of money that will enable you to purchase items of great value.
A lot of money, she says.
This appears to be coinage of a variety that was used for currency during this time period.
Put that stick away, Jim. Put that stick away, Jim.
Mm-hmm.
Put that stick away, Jim.
Why? She likes it rough. I just want to see their reactions in here.
I told you I wasn't bluffing. We three kings will take the stake.
If I didn't know your good luck was only temporary, I'd be quite annoyed.
I have so few vices in my life, I must do the best I can with what I have.
Whose deal is it?
I apologize if you can hear that, guys. People are setting off fireworks for 4th of July, but today is July 1st.
Perhaps some other time.
I could use a drink right now. I could use a drink right now.
So have a drink right now.
I do not think so.
I will never understand human emotion, but this action seems even more unwarranted than many I have seen from your species. I will never understand.
Yeah.
If you want to beat someone, Captain, try poker.
I've done that. I took all your money.
If you want to beat someone, Captain, try poker. If you want to...
All right. I just want to see what would happen.
Save new game. Replace...
What happens if I just give someone all this money?
Nine. Let us poor Germans play poker in peace. Nine. Let us... Nine.
All right. How about I bribe you to leave me alone?
Let's not throw money around. Let's not throw money... Let's not throw...
Okay. What if I give these people money?
Captain, I suggest we keep the money. Given its importance in this century, it will inevitably come in useful.
But I'm so generous.
Captain, I suggest...
All right. That's by the clock. And finally, we'll have gotten the first Horcrux. I'll be one step closer to defeating Voldemort. That's right.
That's just enough to buy this neat clock.
All that money just for the neat clock? Damn. Easy come, easy go. Yeah, look at it first.
This clock is a marvelous piece of workmanship.
You need to destroy it, right?
The clock's power readings are beyond the ability of the tricorder to measure.
So how do we destroy it?
Are you having difficulty with the clock, Captain?
Let's fill it with schnapps.
Are you having difficulty? Are you having
difficulty with the clock? Does this kid have anything new to say?
Hi, can I help you?
What do you want for those shoes?
I'm sorry, but those shoes have already been paid for. My boss would fire me if he caught me drinking this.
So cute.
Save it for Trelane. No, on second thought, hanging's too good for him.
Very funny, Bones.
I was joking?
I was joking? Question.
Shouldn't we leave discipline to the boy's parents?
Save new game. Replace.
I don't think it would let me give back the clock, but just in case.
Enjoying your new toy, Jim?
Alright, let's go. I don't think any of the people in here would have anything to say about the clock, but just in case.
My wonderful clock! I see that you have purchased it.
Yes, yes.
Trying to pass the time away, Jim?
I always got time for you, babe.
Trying to pass the time away, Jim?
I wonder how we destroy the clock.
How touching. I'm supposed to do some things with that?
Or a pocket watch is more convenient.
How touching. How touching. How touching.
A touching. You're touching. Alright, let's go. Wait a second. Can we talk to this guy again? How do we help his kid again? We have to go back to the armory?
Welcome, friends. Can I help you?
What can you tell me? What can you tell me about the... I need you to spread...
You say you need me to convince Herr Schiller to give you the kindergarten blackboard?
Issue a transfer for your son. Alright. So I guess we're headed back there. And then we need to head back here. If we can accomplish that. This is a long... long episode. The only thing back there that I can tell that we've been to is the plane. This guy still in here?
Hello, Gleamgold.
Well, guests again. We like to just walk in, you know.
I was never very fond of schnapps, Colonel. My wife liked it, though.
For Kitty?
Captain, that's no way to treat someone's pet.
Trying to get it drunk.
Herr Eckhart has not shown himself to be a threat. I do not understand why you wish to escape.
I think the cat would prefer string.
Alright, string.
Captain, that's against regulations.
The cat appears to be docile.
It's a bat. It's a bat cat.
We don't need the time, Jim. We don't need the time, Jim.
Alright, let's go. Just visiting, saying hello, giving you weird stuff. Let's save before we go back in here.
Save new game, replace, delete previous, replace.
Let's see if we can convince this guy. I don't know how we can convince him. We probably need to go off to, you know, this way. Get something else.
Are you deaf, Kirk? Get out!
Oh, well.
The band has given up.
Alright, so we need to do something else. Well, wait a second. Snaps?
A drink from you?
Oh, try that. What do you think of this clock?
I see no practical purpose for doing that. I see no practical...
I assume I tried whacking them with the stick and stuff.
You're trying to provoke me.
Yeah. Alright.
Unless we subdue the soldiers, Captain.
Alright, let's go. Clock?
That clock looks like it's broken, sir.
Wasn't this the good clock?
That clock looks like it's broken, sir. That clock looks like it's broken, sir.
Oh, so you speak for everyone.
That clock looks like it...
Oh, you even speak for the teacher. That must be a nice situation for you. I don't know. All right, before we continue... I'm saving a lot, but... Let's see, what's this way? It's 2.5 hours already. It's easily going to be 6 episodes long.
I can't believe the trench would be so close to the town.
It shouldn't be. At this point in the war, the Allies had broken through the trenches. That's why Germany surrendered. Their defenses were crumbling, and they didn't want to see their cities destroyed.
Only one of many illogical situations, Commander. The building where we were imprisoned almost burned to the ground, but no other building was touched. And no one seemed concerned about the fire.
What else?
The fact that everyone seems to recognize us, yet the military does not try to intercept us.
Notice that.
The building signs in English instead of German. There is much here that is not what it seems.
Yet we're limited to it's his own imagining.
James T. Kirk looks out on the battered landscape and keeps his thoughts to himself. Mr. Spock analyzes the situation and wonders why there is not more destruction. Lieutenant Commander Ellis feels a kinship with the dead.
Is he dead?
McCoy is aghast at the landscape, which represents the brutality of his human ancestry. A lone soldier groans, but does not move.
What are you talking about the dead? He's alive.
Young human male, life signs failing. Suffering from internal bleeding and shock. Now that's an odd reading. It's not biological. Maybe Spock should try using his tricorder.
Okay, in a moment.
A crater, created by artillery fire. And no birds sang.
Huh.
Rubble. An artillery shell has collapsed part of the trench. A ladder, which allowed soldiers to climb out of the trench and die more quickly. A crude platform used to support the soldiers when they fired their rifles. A trench, not quite as muddy as you were expecting. Is this German or Allied territory?
Good question.
Is this German or Allied territory? Barbed wire, used to confine soldiers to their moats of mud.
I thought it was used to keep the enemy out.
Army engineers have begun building a tunnel here. The tunnel has barely been started. A trench. Is this German or...
My tricorder detects nothing unusual about this battlefield. My tricorder detects nothing unusual about this trench.
This battlefield, this trench.
My tricorder detects nothing unusual about the rubble. My tricorder detects nothing unusual about the platform.
Nothing unusual anywhere, huh?
The tricorder detects... The tunnel only extends about 3 meters beneath the surface. My tricorder detects nothing unusual about this battlefield.
Crater?
The tricorder detects...
Barbed wire?
Barbed wire. My tricorder detects nothing unusual about this object. The tricorder detects...
Okay, so you wanted us to look at him with Spock's tricorder.
Captain, another abnormally high reading emanating from an object in his pocket. A locket of some sort.
The next horcrux.
No effect. No effect.
We need that locket. Alright, heal him. If you can.
That's odd. I should be able to see immediate improvement in his injuries. But I have no response.
That is because Trelane is interfering. This man is meant to be a dying soldier.
Yep.
Whose presence provides drama for Trelane's production.
He'll die.
Logic suggests that Trelane will not allow him to die except for dramatic effect. Given the inconsistencies I've noticed, it is probable that he may be kept alive indefinitely.
Can you give him something for the pain, Doctor?
Nothing I've done has any effect on him, Command.
Everyone's talking normally except for McCoy, who is whispering.
It's hard to believe that I'm from the same species that could create such carnage.
We improved, but that's damning with faint praise. How come these planet-side missions always end up being so damn cheerful?
This battlefield does not truly represent the misery that was your first World War. A single soldier where there would be dozens.
Right.
Dirt where there should be mud. Trelane is not providing an accurate depiction of this war, Captain.
At least we have one thing to thank him for, Mr. Spock.
That's because he doesn't know about it. Everything that's shown up here is limited to his knowledge and his imagination.
Think of it. Millions of young kids enthusiastically signing up for a war without purpose, dying without reason, by the orders of commanders who don't care.
Here we go again.
It's too bad that things haven't changed much in the last 400 years. Kids still die meaningless deaths for commanders who don't care.
Uh-huh. Can we talk to this guy?
Nothing to report in the West.
What can you tell me about the war? What can you tell me about Trelane? About your locket. What can you tell me about the war?
I am a sentry. The others are dead. I think I'm dying.
Where are they?
Nothing to report in the West.
What can you tell me about the war? What can you tell me about Trelane?
I like to watch the airplanes fly overhead. The enemy watches them too. And I know we'll have a few minutes of peace. Nothing to report in the West.
What can you tell me? About your locket.
You want my locket? But that's the only reminder of my girl. I'd rather lose my arm.
We need it very badly. If we do something for you, would you give it to us?
I have a letter to my girl. If you see that it is delivered, I'll give you my locket.
Who's your girl?
Nothing to report in the West.
What can you tell me? What can you tell me about the war?
I am a sentry.
This letter.
My dearest Hilda, you are the sun that lights my shadows.
The spy?
Your voice is the one that speaks to
Hilda?
Me when all other voices are filled with pain. Only your memory keeps this unbearable suffering from driving me mad. That and the hope that this war will soon end, one way or another, and that I may yet live to see your smile.
Oh no, the one in the bar is Greta. Is the school teacher Hilda?
ordinary piece of paper made from the pulp of dead trees.
Thank you. I had no idea what paper was made out of.
Jim, are you crazy?
He's still whispering.
I really don't feel like a drink right now.
It actually might really help.
That is not logical. The soldier is not in physical condition to threaten us. I see no reason to bring out the letter, Captain.
Bring out the letter? Bring out your letter!
We don't need the time, Jim.
All right.
Save new game. Replace.
Can we go in here? I mean, it only extends 3 meters. So that would be enough. Can we go up the ladder? Can't do anything. I was just analyzing.
My tricorder. I am still picking up power readings that are off the scale from the soldier's locket. My tricorder.
All right, anyone else want to do anything? Guess not. How do I get back? This way? Now, I'm wondering if Hilda is the school teacher. That's the armory. Just has a school look about it, I guess. We were just leaving.